Cast down reasonings or arguments. Genesis chapter 3 verses 1 to 6. Now the serpent was more cunning than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said to the woman, "Has God indeed said, 'You shall not eat of every tree of the garden?'" And the woman said to the serpent, "We may eat the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, 'You shall not eat it, nor shall you touch it, lest you die.'" Then the serpent said to the woman, "You will not surely die, for God knows that in the day you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So the woman saw that the tree was good for food, it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree desirable to make one wise. And she took of its fruit and ate. And she also gave to her husband with her, and he ate. We are talking about casting down imaginations, arguments, reasonings. And if we look at this record in Genesis 3 of how Satan dealt with Eve, he argued with her in a very subtle way about so as to question what God had said. So he began with the question, did God say you shouldn't eat up any of the tree? Eve responded very correctly. No, there's only one tree he said we can't eat of. The serpent said, you know, there's a reason why God didn't want you to eat it. Now that was deception. He was presenting an untruth as though it was a truth. And he was presenting it as part of her reasoning, as part of her logic, as part of an argument to displace the truth that God had spoken to Adam and Eve. So we got to be careful that many times these arguments come into our mind, these reasonings come in, and as Paul wrote, they exalt themselves against the knowledge of God. In other words, these imaginations, these arguments, these reasonings are so overpowering, they are so overbearing, they so grip our minds that they even rise up against the very knowledge of God, against the very truth that God has given to us in His Word, which we are know of. They try to displace that. And now you and I have a choice. Do I cast down that argument? Do I cast down that reasoning? Do I cast down that imagination, knowing that it is opposing the very Word of God? Or do I let it become bigger and dominate my mind, and I actually reject the knowledge of the Word of God? Paul said, we've got weapons by which we must cast down these arguments, these reasonings, these imaginations, and we must take every thought obedient to Christ. Don't let any argument, reasoning, or imagination occupy your mind so that they become bigger than the knowledge of God's Word. Live by the Word. Let the Word of God, let the truth of God occupy your mind, and you cast down the reasonings, arguments, and imaginations that try to contradict the truth of God. Let's pray. Lord, we pray that you'll help us be vigilant in our minds, that when thoughts, arguments, reasonings, imaginations come in that contradict your Word, that we will be careful to cast them down and to take every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.